What is true love to me? True love is a journey. It's a story. It's something that two people create and maintain. I define love the way that the Bible defines love in 1 Corinthians chapter 13 by verse 7. It says that love hopes all things, believes all things, bears all things, and believeth all things. And I apply that to my life and the way that I love.
So true love to me is selflessness. When I'm not concerned about myself because I know my girl got me, and she's not concerned with herself because she know I got her. The only way I feel like you can truly, truly love somebody and just open up yourself to them and like just have that genuineness is if you just lose all the little selfish habits we have. Because too many times we argue and fight and all that kind of stuff because we trying to look out for us or make sure we get taken care of. But if we had that genuine trust, knowing that our significant other, you know what I mean, gonna always have our best interests in mind, it allows us to really, you know what I mean, express the way we feel about them in just the purest way we can, which is true love, selflessness.
True love is defined as your perception of it and not the world's. The way I show my true love is through my girlfriend, in which I treat her as my heart, my queen, you know, that's my wifey, and I love you, and she knows who she is, Kenesha Day, and happy Valentine's Day, baby.
What is true love to me? True love is when you wake up in the morning and she's that first person you think about and she's the last thing you think about before you go to bed. True love is when knowing she compliments you, knowing that where you weak, she's strong, and where you're strong, she's weak, and you guys just fit together. True love is when you arguing, right? You mad as shit, and you know, you thinking like, shit, now I know I'm mad, but I know I'm gonna call her back. I know I love her. Love, true love is unconditional, so you can always be there for her. And that's what I think true love is to me.
What are the things I look for in a woman? There's four qualities that I hold myself to that I think my woman should also have. There's school, church, gym, work. School, you've got to be educated. I love a woman that can have an intelligent conversation. Church, you got to be God-fearing. Without God, there is no relationship in my eyes. Gym, you don't have to be a model. You do not have to be a model. But just love yourself. Take care of yourself. Then finally, work. I love supporting women at the same time. Y'all can get expensive. We love y'all, but we need that same support back. Those are four qualities that will definitely up your standards with Ryan Scott. So hopefully y'all are working on that.
I look for in a woman is somebody that's very intellectual, somebody that can hold a great conversation with me. Also, somebody that I can go to church with. Oftentimes, I find myself at church on Sundays. It's a big thing, big portion of my life. So somebody that I could do that with would also be a positive. Another thing, I love a girl that could dress, somebody real classy, knows her style, has her own swag with the way she do things. Also, when we have on dates, we have fun, chill, eat, watch a movie or something like that. Whatever we're doing, we're having fun, and at the end of the day, we're going back to the house and chilling.
Alright, what I look for in a woman, the first thing, I want my woman to be independent. I want her to have a solid career so we both can work together to achieve the finer things in life. Secondly, I want my woman to be supportive. I mean, if I'm not feeling too well, I want her to be there to make that chicken noodle soup and make sure your boy is feeling good. Thirdly, I want to have a good time with my woman. So no matter what we do, any activity, no matter where we go, I want it to be cracking. And that's what I look for in a woman.
What I look for in a woman is a very ambitious woman. You know, I'm a very ambitious man, so I need somebody to compliment my swag. I also look for somebody that has culinary skills because your boy loves to eat. Also like, you know, a God-fearing woman, someone that's in the church. Also would love somebody I can take my time with, you know, someone that's not in a rush. I'm a young man, so I'm not in a rush to do anything yet.
If I had to put together a magic date with my special one, it would start off with breakfast. It'd be a day. It wouldn't even be a date. I'd dedicate a whole day to her. It'd start off with a breakfast, you know, make her breakfast. We both eat. And then I take her shopping at her favorite store, and I buy her a dress that she would wear for that night. I'll probably kick the night off with some dinner at her favorite restaurant, and then conclude it with an activity that I'd like to do, like miniature golf or some laser tag. That way, both people get what they want out of the date, and everybody has fun. And that's me signing off.
And my idea of a good date would be probably having my girl, shout out Crystal with Tees, at the crib, watching some type of movie on Netflix in high definition, because
You know, you got to do the big to stand up and create, you know. And with the downturn of the economy, it saves money, you know what I'm saying? So it's always good to be saving and investing in, you know, good fellowship. So it would be a day, or I guess a night, watching a few Netflix films, you know, and then I'll probably just wrap that up with some form of meal that I'll make, because I do like to cook.
So my most romantic date would probably start off having dinner seaside, nice restaurant, seafood, sunset, definitely a perfect time. A lot of windows, seeing boats and things come in. Obviously want to wrap up pretty quick because I'd have more surprises for later on. We'd have to get back to the car, but there's one thing I'd have to always ask you is if you can trust me. Because once you get in my car, I have to blindfold you, because there's no way you can know where we're going. Probably take you somewhere nice, maybe even a gondola ride, if you're really special enough. Go around there, see a couple of different people's houses, seeing the light of the tide come in. Just a time for me and you. And probably wrap that back up, get back on shore, have a little time on the beach, and make sure I get you back to tuck you in.
Stuck, trapped inside of her seduction, losing my mind each and every time she's around. Oh yeah, tell Scotty beat me up. Am I in another world? Oh, Miss Lady Luck, hadn't met the perfect girl. So could this be true loving that I found? Oh yeah,
don't know what to do. So baby, how? Keep my heart.